shaft into the deep, inner depths of the diamond mine, where we will witness the flight of the precious peanut butter fudge angel of love as she spreads her wings and flies high through the thundering silence of your vacuum-kept secret, hiding out in the pulsating fringe of your bubbly fudge mind. Deep in the sanctuary of the ruby-lipped lizard who stripped through that revolving door of today's changes, springs the weightless suspension of those tiny red question marks to pierce your brain and taunt you to observe the wondrous smoke of the fur-lined volcano near the cave of the great blue-winged bat following the flight of the deep, deep-breathing butterfly toward the soothing smell of the six-foot narcissus. Are we in the garden of man-eating dandelions or in the safety of the Tasmanian treehouse? Can it be? Will it be? Yes, it will, as you reach out for where it's at, only to find when you're where it's at, it isn't where it's at all. So pop out now with me for a borrowed moment and glimpse through the plate glass menagerie of life, the time thieves, the blight of mediocrity. Will we ever free ourselves of the demons of mediocrity? Wade now with me, knee deep in the splendor of the peach fuzz forest, in the gentle radiation of the one-eyed cufflink, who joins us on our ball-bearing express to the land of lavender and sky blue pink, where we pause on the latex trampoline of tomorrow's promise and grieve on yesterday's sweet sorrow. In the steam-heated living room of the warm teenage tangerine, we must now somersault in slow motion down, down the sliding board to a diamond mine eternity, crying, crying as God alive.